Okay, just up at the yard, doing even more work on getting this plug as good or better than it needs to be. Now, I did fiberglass over the foam a day or two ago. Should have tissued it, but didn't. Reasons. So, to fill the fiber pattern, I've just gone over it with some top coat. Now my next stage is to flat that back some and then apply multiple coats by brush that it's better suited to being sprayed. Duratec is one of the brands. So basically a primer coat that you can flat back to basically a glass-like finish, and then we make the mold off of that. So that is going to go off in the name of patience. I'm just going to let that go off all day today, Saturday afternoon. There's no massive sense of urgency on this. I want this one right this time above the other one. So let's get back to the conservatory, let's get back to base, because I want to talk to you about the internet. And in particular, what I want to talk to you about is this polyurethane foam sheet. In its 1-inch variant and its 1/2-inch variant that I use 99% of the time. Okay, so once again, the internet strikes like it did yesterday with catching that person plagiarizing, stealing my intellectual material, altering it for his own gains. Now, what do you think I should do about that? Another topic for another video, maybe. So where else did the internet strike today that I noticed? Now, I do keep my eye on the internet. I keep my eye on koi forums, Facebook pages, to see what's being said. And I'll put a screen grab up there of what was said about foam lining by somebody. I'm actually a member of that forum. I don't go on there getting involved with arguments and ending up bickering with people over things. But I do dip my toe in the water and have a look in on there now and again. And I read that, what you've just seen about foam, disintegrating, whatever. Now, let's wind the clock back 20 years. Let that figure, 20 years, just sit there in your mind for a minute, right? Beyond 20 years ago, all koi ponds used to be rendered. And I would turn up to the ponds. Some of them would be rendered lovely and flat, say by a pro plasterer, renderer. Some of them would be less than good. Some of them would be absolute garbage. Most of them, because of the conduction of heat from the resin to a cold surface like render, at any time of the year, we would just across the board use 2 450s of glass. That would build up enough heat, and it would build up enough heat that any conduction of heat wouldn't affect how the resin went off. And it also overcame the less than perfect undulating surfaces of a lot of rendered ponds. And I was, for a long time, it was racking on my brains. What can we do to negate the rendering process that either the customer can do or I can do as part of a package? And I saw somebody on, I think that forum's defunct now, like some of them go like Koi Vista, more on that if I remember to talk about it, where I had hundreds of examples of my work, but a guy called Tony Warriner used to run it, kind of alongside the Yorkshire Koi Forum. Anyway, A person off an other forum, possibly defunct now, he basically put a wooden board into the window recess and sprayed polyurethane foam, which is basically part A, part B, mix it up, put it in the container and spray it. It's like the stuff you put in your loft. Now, to get a finish suitable to fiberglass on, he's power sanding it down for days to get it flat. And I'm like, hang on a minute. Foam sheet is available. We can use that. I put that out as a thing, yeah? I remember the first customer that did it. I remember the first year it was done, 2004. That's 20 years ago. Customer put the foam on. We went along, myself and Mick, who's now dead, unfortunately. Good glasser. We went and fiberglassed it. That was where the foam lining revolution started in this country. That is an absolute fact. I was the first person to go out and do polyurethane foam sheets on people's ponds. Okay. Then another fiberglasser came along, attempting to discredit my methods. Okay. On about it, crushing. And saying that Celotex is better and Reticel, whatever, these are better than the one I use, right? I ran over some of it in whatever van I had at that time 20 years ago. I videoed it and drove over it, sandwiched between two pieces of ply. Minimal, and I mean minimal compression. Videoed it and put it on a forum. You know what this AN of a fiberglasser that nobody hears of these days, he's gone, he's done. Thankfully, he said, that's not a fair test because of the weight transfer of the axle across the wheels. I'm like, I tell you what, you come here and put your hands under that wheel. See how much weight is transferred to the other wheel through the axles. How can you come out with a statement like that? Ridiculous. Anyway, back to the topic of what was said on the internet that the foam... Basically, this is a very widely spread myth, misnomer, or lie. Yeah, that this foam that I use, polyurethane, you've just seen some of it in the unit, it disintegrates and it crushes. Now, what I've done as part of my research in this video to back up what I'm saying, I've made a note on that board of exactly how many customers over 20 years, bearing in mind a sheet of that foam is 1.2 meters by 0.6 meters thereabouts. Yeah, how many sheets of that foam do you think I've applied to the walls of koi ponds in 20 years? So I've made a note on my board of exactly how many reports or complaints customers have made to me that the foam has crushed and compromised the fiberglass and caused a problem. That's exactly how many. Exactly. None. Not one. Ever in 20 years. I think after year two or year one, if there were any complaints about how it responds to being fiberglassed, having tons of water put on top of it on the bottom of a pond, I think that would have shown itself up to be a method that really shouldn't be pursued. It might have been an idea, yeah, that should have just stayed in the mind. None. No failures. How many ponds do you think my customers have extended either the length of or the width of that have already been foam lined by myself? Quite a few. How many times have the customers cut into the walls, cut through the fiberglass, cut through the foam and cut through the wall, and we've extended onto the existing fiberglass? I've got photographs on my computer. If I could be bothered To go through that computer with thousands of photographs on it, I could find at least one example where the existing foam on the floor of the pond that had been installed for 2 years before the customer extended the pond, yeah, that was the existing. I offered a piece of brand new foam to the extension, and guess what? Identical thickness. Identical. No compression at all. In 5 feet depth of water. No compression. Now, as I do keep my eye on these forums, on these Facebook pages, all over the internet, YouTube as well, how many cases have you heard of somebody's foam crushing? Whether it's the stuff I use or what A and other fiberglassers use, or whether they even put it on the floor because they're frightened out of their minds that it might crush, yeah? I think that's what puts them off doing it. They're just fiberglass over a crap concrete floor. If the walls are crap, there stands the chance that the floor's going to be crap as well, which they are. And if people have, I've said this a million times, if people have got this attitude where, oh, I'm not bothered what it looks like, it's deep down, go and hire someone else. Fiberglass it yourself, or chuck a liner in it if you don't care. Fiberglass is meant to look professional and smart, in my opinion. One of these koi tuber types, right, who kind of learned how to do fiberglassing, watching countless hours of my videos, absolute fact, he fiberglassed his, one of his own ponds. He said, oh, I'm not fiberglassing near the drain because it crushes. And then the fiberglass will move with it as the foam compresses downwards, yeah? Didn't use my foam. Didn't go anywhere near that drain. How often do you see my pond, or my customers' ponds, where I foam line right up to the drain like that and then put that rounded edge and then glass down there? I do that for a few reasons. One reason is quite often the drain might be a little bit out and not level. Or the concrete or the skim or whatever just might not be level. And that brings things a lot, you know, it makes a tidier finish. If that foam was going to crush and then dislodge the fiberglass downwards, and this is not why I put polyurethane sealant here, yeah, that is well documented that I will do in a lot of cases. That's to do with if water's coming up the pond, pushing at the fiberglass, yeah? Why do I go up to the edges on 99% of the jobs that I do? So, a question over to you guys. How many documented cases are there in this country of any foam, and in particular the one I use, of it crushing to any point that it disrupts or compromises the fact? I can't find any documented cases anywhere. You don't think my customers would be complaining to me if something went wrong? Matt, you installed the foam. It's your problem. It's on you. I want this fixing. It doesn't happen. This A and other fiberglasser, thankfully he's gone. He had a problem with a job, documented on some forum forums used to be the thing before Facebook was a thing and YouTube was a thing, yeah. TikTok or whatever those things are. And he blamed the installation of the foam. Blame shifted it to the customer. Oh, it's the foam's fault. The foam's moved. Well, you should have known about that before you put that fiberglass on. You should have tested at least by pressing on that foam to make sure it was secure. And it wasn't going to bounce so far that it's going to compromise the fiberglass. That's on you. Should have worked that out before you started working. Blame shifting to the customer. Nah, don't work like that. So, unless I don't trawl the internet enough, and there are loads of cases out there of this foam crushing, yeah? Let's get that board filled in with the real numbers. Because my numbers are empty. No. Zero known cases. So rest peacefully in your mind that if I install that foam, I will take responsibility for it. I will take responsibility for what it looks like. I'll take responsibility for it being, for the pond being waterproof for an incredibly long time. 20 years this foam lining system has been in existence. Then another glasser comes along, as I've described. You know, that's crap, that is. With absolutely no evidence of it being crap. Crap, crushing, disintegrating. That other guy did it in that person's back garden, didn't he? He had a piece of foam with him. Oh, it's rubbish. Well, hang on a minute. If it's that bad, how come it works for me? Think about it. So, yeah, that's another case of the internet striking again with information that he hasn't been able to back up with anything. Nothing at all. Anyway, that's a little, not a rant video, but, you know, don't worry about that foam. You worry about a thing when I'm on the job.